The coronavirus is spreading. It's in over 20 countries, and the World Health Organization has declared a global emergency. But there's an underlying virus that's really causing this all to happen. It's called animal exploitation. Health officials said the coronavirus outbreak spread from the Huanan seafood market in Wuhan, China, a city with more people than Chicago and New York combined. Huanan is what's known as a wet market, because vendors slaughter animals right there as customers wait. A customer of Huanan Market was the first to die of the virus, and the market has since been closed. New research suggests that the virus originated with bats. It's possible that someone ate contaminated bat meat, but also possible that a bat infected another animal at the market. The market sold wild animals, which is not uncommon in certain parts of China. There's public outcry over the consumption of wild animals, but this coronavirus outbreak is not unique. Human beings have always caught illnesses from our exploitation of animals, whether wild or farmed. The avian flu pandemic started with birds. The 2009 swine flu pandemic came from pigs. We've also discovered that bats were transmitting Ebola. And now, the risk is increasing. Climate change and environmental destruction are changing animals' natural habitats, which drives them to new areas and increases their interactions with human populations, increasing the risk of outbreak. The coronavirus has infected thousands of people already. Four US states have confirmed cases of coronavirus, including California. The CDC has started screening passengers at 20 airports, including San Francisco, Los Angeles, and New York. The US State Department is telling people not to travel to China and set the new advisory level at level 4, the highest level. Google, Amazon, and Microsoft have closed down their offices in China, and 2,000 Starbucks stores in China have closed for business. But even with thousands of cases of coronavirus, there are far more cases of salmonella, which is caused by animal feces. More than 1 million yearly cases in the United States alone. As long as people are eating animals and traces of their feces, these outbreaks will continue. We need a system-wide solution, but our government is not treating this virus as a symptom of a much bigger problem. Instead, countries outside of China are turning to xenophobia. Tens of thousands of people have signed petitions asking the government to ban Chinese nationals from entering the country. In South Korea and Vietnam, businesses are posting signs indicating that Chinese nationals are not welcome. A French newspaper's front page warned of a, quote, yellow alert, and the US Secretary of Commerce said he thinks the outbreak will help to accelerate the return of jobs to North America. But what we need isn't division or competition. We need to come together as a global population and address the root cause, animal exploitation. And we need to do it before it's too late.